Welcome at the Politics Watch. This is Erpy. Now, today is even more mind-blowing than when time with USA. An eagle eye across all of this. An eagle eye make the whole of the Klansman in the pan trial. Today, the police witness, after being questioned by the judge, Justice Sykes, when time I read them interaction, I had to double check and triple check, quadruple check, if I some kind of error. Maybe at the defense team I asked them question, I could not believe that the judge and the police was having this interaction. The judge for the case, Justice Sykes, was asking the police investigator why C4 wasn't charged. Let me say that again. The judge was asking the police investigator why C4, the star witness, wasn't charged. Tell Mr. Jamaica is not a Netflix series. I know, even when I make the video, it still can't make sense to me. And then the police, I say, there is a possibility that C4 will get charged. A statement that is beyond ludicrous. Matter of fact, give me a couple of seconds while I flood your speakers with redundant big words. Preposterous. Laughable. Absurd. Farcical. One F and understand what I want. Are we supposed to believe that the JCF, after working with a witness who came forward on their own accord and even the policeman confirmed it, after going on operations, real operations, a real shot fly, collecting much intel for JCF, there's a possibility that after testifying and sinking the Klansman gang, that witness might be charged? Not even a Jamaica. Something can go so. Not even in a banana republic pretending to be a nation. Something can go so. I refuse to believe it. That would be a bridge too far. As you can see on your screen, under the line I read, he was not charged because he had not been a suspect in any of the alleged crimes committed by the criminal network. However, he said investigations were ongoing into the self-styled down the road in the gang. But on Friday, Sykes wanted to know why the former gangster was not charged, as Sykes the judge I use. Justice Sykes is using Sykes. This can't be real. Surely, a judge as experienced as Justice Sykes is not really asking why the star witness wasn't charged. A Sykes my use. The man literally named Sykes. Even after the law enforcers heard about several incidents of criminality in which he participated. In response, the police officer said the decision was made not to treat the former gangster as a defendant, but as a civilian witness. The policeman then explained to the judge that the anti-gang legislation allows for former members of gangs to testify against them former cronies without getting any kind of charges or prosecution. Justice Sykes is not aware of this, or Sykes the judge I use. Sykes the judge I use, he cannot convince me that Justice Sykes is not aware of this. He cannot convince me that Justice Sykes have asked why you wouldn't charge a star witness. If you go to Woolmer's Boys, take any grade 11 student and ask them, do you know why you wouldn't charge a star witness, especially one who came forward on their own accord in a trial, they will give you the answer. Justice Sykes, I use Sykes, this cannot be real. Cannot be a serious question, Sykes. And you can check it out for yourself, man, Luke. What the judge then asked, it said, let me get a direct quote. Sykes further pressed the policeman by asking whether the prosecution's second witness, aka C4, will ever be charged relative to the incidents in the case. Is that even a... This is why I was wondering why the defense asked question, you know. Because I was... When my first year, I said, no, I must defense ask that. Because the defense asked, so, you know, I got charged C4 for him, I say. But the judge asked, I refuse to believe this. Sykes, the judge I use. Justice Sykes is using Sykes. Not even Jamaica would even attempt something like this. Not even Jamaica, a country notorious for gimmicks, would ever pull a stunt like this. Are you going to charge your star witness? Especially one that you and them go on operations with, collect intel, risk life, right? Then go quarters, and then when trial done, you go say, all right, time for you to go jail. Not even Jamaica this can happen. I refuse to buy, I'm not buying this one. I would buy my own unicorn before I buy this. As you can see from your screen, under cross-examination, them ask him, what kind of investigation are you doing to C4? And the policeman said, that's them run them checks, and he did not surface as a suspect. I'm telling already about this. The time period where people in the Klansman system think that C4 became a wanted man, now we know that he was already working with C-Tac. So he couldn't have been a wanted man. What Klansman think him wanted for, i.e. the operation where Sus and Razim lose him life, he was already working with C-Tac. At that Klansman thing C4 wanted for. Because remember, he was on that mission. So all of a sudden, him gets scared and can't see him. Right? When him ask him where they, him tell him same affair hide car police are look for him. It only made sense. He was on the mission. Right? So said Razim dead man run up and down. Them other things say him run up and down to him a wanted man. He was already working with C-Tac. And even if he was wanted, even if he was behind bars serving 50 years, that wouldn't mean say him can't testify at the trial. Right? As we have seen it before. So they're clutching at straws. And as me say, me expect the defense team, right, to try them best to try to save them clients. I still can't understand what the judge really asked. If the JCF was to charge C4 after this trial, it would go down as the biggest farce in criminal history. Jamaica and the JCF would be used as a case study in law enforcement training colleges all around the world, in justice system training courses all around the world, in criminology courses all around the world, in law schools all around the world. Jamaica and the JCF would be the case study on how to be a poppy show. They would never ever get another witness for a gang trial. Who you think are going to sit down and watch and see for the all of this and then get charged and then come testify in our next trial? Only not in a sense. Why would anybody see a witness who went forward on his own accord, who could easily just not say nothing and make clan still the road to this day? Go to the police, give them information, confess, tell them what him do to, tell them where they go, go upon other operations with the police, go to quarters, then after all of that, get charged, and then end up in a jail house with the same man them him help sink, right, and then think to themselves, you know what, I'm going to go testify in a courthouse too. After seeing what happened to C4, me I go testify too. Are you people insane? Let me say this can't real. Troll them a troll. They're trolling. There simply cannot be any plans to charge C4 after this. And the fact that C4 is still testifying in the courthouse, because if you ever charge me, me not nothing more to say no. So the fact that he's still testifying, show me say, no charge not come out of this. I'm telling the people in Jamaica right now, even though we know say, this is Jamaica, the land of woodwater and gimmicks, right? C4, our witness one, can't get charged. Because I will not be exaggerating when I tell you, that would be the end, and listen to me carefully, that would be the end of anti-gang legislation trials as you know it. There would be no more cases, there would be no more anti-gang trials if people see a C4 or a witness one get charged. There will be no more, I'm not exaggerating. They cannot win cases without witnesses, and no witness now go forward if they will get charged anyway. How would that make sense? Why would I go to you with information, open up a operation video, tell people say I'm an uncle, right, record stuff, only if you know say, me will get charged. Why would I? That don't make no sense at all. This is one big joke, one big misunderstanding, and let's just pretend like this day never happened in our quarters. Let's not pretend like, right, we didn't just hear a senior judge ask a senior policeman why you never charged a star witness and if you're going to charge a star witness. Let's just put this day behind us, right? Let's hope that BBC, let's hope that Fox News and CNN and all these international, let's just hope them that catch no wind of this. Because I wouldn't even want the world for hear say this was even mentioned. We wouldn't even want the world for hear say this was even put forth as an idea for charges. Let's just put this behind us, move on. Right? We're going to put this in a little box and throw it over a flat bridge. If there are any foreigners listening to this video, let me just reaffirm that this is all just a big comedy skit. You know, in Jamaica, we love, you know, when we look at joking from time to time. So this is a joke. Mr. Foreigner, I don't want you to go tell nobody. Say Jamaica is a country where star witnesses might end up get charged after confessing and giving too much intel to the police. Right, so Mr. Foreigner, Billy Joan Gwinnett, nobody make a documentary. It's just one big joke. All right? You just, you don't really understand the culture, you don't get it. Right, but it's all a joke. Nobody teaches in there. Lecture halls them, nobody teaches my your law degree them, and nobody use Jamaica as a case study. If you fool people in all the sense, right? It's all a big joke. Right? The JCF will not be charging us D4. Right? And Justice Sykes know exactly why, right, the witness was not charged. Anyway, business squad, big up himself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Bless.